Go for it.
Okay, go, JJ. So, guys, we are like with the best caster team online here, Firebat, the ex-world championship champion, and Purple.
Thanks for rubbing it in.
Come on.
How does that feel? Does it feel good?
Oh, it feels great. Oskaka's a great guy, clearly better than me. I'm glad if he took the title. He's worked a lot harder than me in the last month or so. So I think he really deserves it, to be honest with you.
Cool. So Navi jacket on Surrender?
Yeah, it looks like Navi
Breaking
might
news.
Be picking up Surrender. He's
Breaking
got the jacket
news.
On and everything.
I guess we just got a new Navi member right there. This Navi lineup of players, it seems like really strong.
Yeah, and that jacket's sick. I want one.
It's the only jacket I've seen that's yellow and black that doesn't make you look like a bumblebee. Like, they pulled it off very well, the color scheme. I'm really impressed with them.
I'm pretty excited for this upcoming match, bro. Like, Surrender, like, a huge upcomer and a really good player.
Yeah, he was,
he
like...
He beat me the last time I played him. I'm
so he did?
Like, super high up in, like, the points on Korea or whatever. He had, like, 385 or something.
That, what?
Yeah, the
for
most
the BlizzCon points?
Yeah, most BlizzCon points out of any player.
That's insane.
Out of any region, yeah.
So, he made, like, basically rank one every month.
Yeah, and he seems really focused, really determined. He didn't talk to too many players. He's just been, like, zoning out, doing his own thing, practicing.
He's actually focused while the rest of us are having fun.
Yeah, everyone's, like, partying, and he's just like, I'm here to win it. I'm going to take it all.
I mean, this place is, like, super chill. Like,
Yeah, it's really chill, and he is... He's in his own world.
He's actually trying to win.
He's too
so he's probably going to win.
too competitive for the chill.
Yeah. Oh, man.
Yeah.
They even have, like, an own cinema right there. It's, like, super sick.
Yeah. And there's, like, Dance Dance Revolution and...
Yeah, I'm not doing that yet. That's risky business.
Maybe. I mean, that's for later when everybody's too hammered to really know that you suck.
And the cameras are off.
We gotta make sure that happens, too.
So, who are you rooting for, guys?
Well, I mean... I'm rooting for Orange. I mean, look at his hair.
Yeah. Look at the hair, though.
Honestly, it's not as good as it usually is.
So you say, like, Surrender Third is bad?
Like, he just flew... He just flew here, and
it's
a bit, like, below what it usually is, but it still looks good.
He normally flies, and he usually misses his flight because he has too many hair products.
Oh, here we go.
They have to stall him out at security.
Druid Mirror.
Oh, man.
Surprise.
Double Wild Growth, so we're going to see a competitive game.
Oh. I mean, one
player has Innervate.
What is stronger,
Orange is about to fetch away the Shredder.
Is that... That's not, like, what are you supposed to have?
I'd keep the Shredder and the Druid Glow. That's a good curve.
Hey, he's going greedy. He's trying to get the coin Wild Growth into three. Yeah. Is he maybe saying... Neither Aggro Druid plays... Aggro Druid doesn't play Wild Growth.
Yeah,
both are playing mid-range Druid.
They're both playing mid-range, and no Fel Reaver Shenanigans should be involved.
Yeah.
And Surrender?
Keeper's
not good.
So they... I mean, what is better, like, Wild Growth into Shredder or Wild Growth and Innervate on one hand? I guess Wild Growth into Shredder is, like, about the best thing you can get.
All right. Orange has a big dream of this Emperor.
Orange took a risky mulligan there. He was going big because he saw his opponent keep two cards, so he figured, I need to really have the absolute stone cold nuts to win this game. So he mulliganed away an okay hand.
This is, like, really strong. Like,
yeah.
This is not looking
Innervate
good.
Shade's insane.
Wow.
That is dirty.
That shade really often makes, like, a difference in the mirror. Like, if somebody gets the shade out early, you develop more creatures.
Wait. You're telling me if you innervate out a minion on turn one that grows forever, it makes a difference?
Yes. It's good.
Wow. Thanks for that useful tip.
Curve stone.
Yeah, it's looking like Orange is actually pretty much going to need to pick up his own innervate to catch up in this game.
Well, he definitely needs a creature. That's step one. But, I mean, like, Surrender doesn't really have too much following behind this. He's relying off the top of his deck to really find something here.
Yep.
Otherwise, he's forced to play a subpar minion as Keeper of the Grove.
All right, well, Orange got rewarded. He got his Shredder back.
I mean, the Coin Emperor is insane.
Yeah, Shredder Coin Emperor is a good curve.
Yeah.
He got the low fab. Is he going to Keeper of the Face?
Oh yes.
Yeah, you Keeper of the Face.
It's two is good.
Kipo, yeah, Kappa,
it's
Kipo.
Just better than SI. You don't even have to combo that bad boy out.
And honestly, I would swing with the shade too, because I don't really mind if they swipe it, because they surrender all the tempo back to you and you get your turn to free develop Lothep.
Yeah, exactly. Like, Lothep on a good board like that seems good.
Yeah, pushes a lot of damage. So I would swing with the shade, keep her the face, and get ready just to Lothep and then hammer the point home.
Yeah, that's how it works, the mirror, right?
Yeah, Druid damage.
Just going to draw the combo on back of that.
Oh, yeah, eventually you do, because you got all the cycle with the lords, you got Azure Drakes. Like, it's just statistically, you're likely to hit the combo.
It's kind of interesting. Like, it happens very often in Mirror. One gets, like,
Favoring the big game owner and not attacking.
Not attacking, that's interesting.
I guess he wants to just go with a huge swing, turn with low fab, and just maybe silence taunt after that. Seems decent. Yeah.
He's going to try and like hope maybe Orange doesn't have a 4-drop here since Orange mulliganed so many cards, I guess, and then try and get the big swing turn with Lothar.
This Lothar is going to be disgusting because Orange is playing a Shredder this turn, and then he's going to want a Coin Emperor, and that's not going to happen. And he doesn't have a play so far.
Yep, this is dirty.
So that's 9 right to the dome. And this Ancient of Lore pickup is quite huge.
Yep.
A reload for his depleted hand.
So that Lothar basically protects the board, doesn't allow him to Coin Emperor. Seems like decent.
Really good, especially since Orange doesn't have a 5-drop, which is a bummer for him, because otherwise, if he doesn't pick one up, he's doing nothing this turn in the face of this huge board.
Like, oh.
I mean, in 2 turns, you got that big game under for that Shade. Are you dead first, though?
Wow, this hand is so spell-heavy. Yeah. He was lucky to pick up the Shredder even again, but now it's like...
Oh, boy.
Yeah. Hero power pass.
Tempo big game hunter. Oh, boy.
I mean, he has to play it here, right?
Kill the Shade?
How are you?
Bloodfang Raptor is pretty good here, though.
He really needed, like, Bluegill Warrior off that Shredder.
That would have been sick.
I mean, he's down at 8 health on turn 6, but doesn't seem too appealing.
Well, Surrender knows better than us, because this Keeper is getting value now.
Yeah, I like this ordering here. This worked out very well. It was impressive.
I guess you just ignore the Bloodfang Raptor and go to the dome.
Oh, yeah.
Face is the place.
You too, man. If I'm practicing with one of you two, like, you're always just saying, JJ, go face, go face.
Well, that's how you win the game. You gotta kill him.
Does this, like, work like that nowadays?
Yes. Yeah. Better than ever because Fel Reaver is in the meta.
I mean...
It goes way faster.
As long as you know you're playing around the removal sources, then you're forcing your opponent to have to trade with you. So if you're not going face, you're just discarding damage from your deck.
Yeah, it makes sense.
Yeah.
World champion advice right there.
Orange has this Emperor card.
Yeah. I mean, this all started from the chain reaction from that Innervate. Just getting the early tempo out on the board. And,
And Orange never doing anything with the coin. So that Lothar was so good.
Yeah, the Lothar was insane.
Good card.
I mean, he's getting punished for the greed there, right? I mean, just going for the super high curve.
Yeah, well, but I mean, like, you got to think about it. Like, you see your opponent's mulligan, and you see that they keep 2 cards. So if they're keeping 2 cards out of their 3 cards, you know they have Innervate and Wild Growth, basically, right?
Yeah, I guess so, yeah.
So you know you need an insane hand if you're going to be able to beat that. So that's kind of why he went greedy with it.
So are you saying to beat you in the Druid Mirror, I just have to just keep my whole hand and you're going to, like, overreact?
Well, I would mulligan an average hand, and then... Okay. If it's an average hand, then I can probably get an average hand back.
On a side note, good Druid player. Just Force Nature for the win.
Turn 7 lethal? That was another class, right?
Yeah. I mean, like, this was going to happen eventually, so...
Oh, man.
Sped up the
process. Is Orange just going to surrender?
Surrender to surrender? Wow. Okay.
Losing Druid Mirror is really bad for Orange here.
Why is that?
Because he has Hunter and what's his other deck?
And Paladin.
I guess you have to go Paladin.
Yeah, Paladin does very well.
You don't really want to queue mid-range Hunter anyways into Druid since Darnassus has been a card. Mm-hmm. It's busted.
What is Surrender's answer to Paladin in his lineup? Because he doesn't have aggro Druid, so he has mid-range Druid, which is traditionally pretty weak to Paladin.
In my opinion, Druid beats everything, so...
I mean, Druid...
maybe the way you draw, but...
just play Druid 3 times. It's good format.
I mean, Druid can just draw sometimes pretty good.
Like he just did. That was really good.
Yeah, I mean...
You just do that 3 times.
If you do that 3 times, you do have a pretty good chance of winning. But I think Paladin can even beat those sort of starts.
Really?
Yeah, Paladin's strong, man.
That's true, yeah.
Yeah, I mean, you get that Mysterious Challenger down.
That's a good card, right?
It's a pretty good one. I like it.
Is it really worth the 400 dust?
400 dust? Yeah, man.
Should I get golden ones?
1600? You don't want to go full role player. That's too much.
And Innervate Shade again.
I'm having a...
That's really good.
I'm having a deja vu right there.
That is... So, he's got the Wrath to clean up whatever minion Orange plays.
Wow, Orange just kind of looks very sad. Orange
has the 1-2 coin 4 curve, though, which isn't bad. So he's got Zombie Chow into Knife Juggler.
This curve from the Paladin, I think if I could choose a hand as a mid-range Paladin, I would take this one.
Decision.
Yeah, that's a big decision.
Like, if he trades the Shade, he opens himself up to coin muster for battle to take care of the remaining Shade. So, And if he just plays the Darnassus, it also opens him up for the Zombie Chow value trading in the Coin Muster, finishing it off.
Yeah.
So it's kind of like a big risk. No, not really a big risk. It's a little risk with a high reward.
Mm-hmm. That, actually, the reward's not that big given his follow-up.
Given his hand,
yeah. Yeah. Given what the hand is, there's actually not that much merit in it. Mm-hmm.
I agree with you. If he had like a play that's a 4-drop, I would go for it. But since he has no 4-drop, why?
But at the same time, your hand sucks. So like,
and swing, right?
Yeah.
2-drop that can kill the shades.
Iron Beak Gal.
I mean, you swing, you play around the Coin Trucer. Makes sense. Push a bit of damage.
Mm-hmm. Is this Secret Paladin from Orange, or is this just straight mid range?
I think it's straight.
He's just straight.
With that hair?
With that hair? Look how good the hair is.
That hair seems Kappa Pride to me. I don't know what you're talking about.
I mean, it's kind of hard. You have, like,
a good play? No.
Everything's disgusting. It looks like he's going to go with a value game.
Oh, boy.
Interesting.
I don't mind it.
He want the Shade to eat a minion, so he can then True Silver down the Shade.
All he ends up doing is, like, just burning resources by not making Nero Bar. I think that was the best play for Orange Chisholm. Yeah.
Otherwise, the Shade eats something, and then he still has to True Silver it.
Unless you hit the juggle, and you draw Monster for battle.
Well, that would be very fortunate thinking.
Yeah.
I don't know. He's
1-2 and like 2-18 out of the top deck. Seems good to me. High percentage plays.
I mean, the other day I juggled a Stealthed Auctioneer with 4 juggles, so it is possible.
That seems pretty average.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Gadget never lives.
Good old esports.
I mean, with this Paladin hand, you can very well go for the value game, and you also have like a Belcher to protect your life.
Yeah.
And Tyrion.
I actually think Orange is in good spot so far. We'll see like what comes off the top for Surrender, but
yeah, he's gonna need like Lothep here or some high value 5-drop.
Cure the Claw.
Ooh,
he's not blanks.
And he really doesn't want to use this Keeper of the Grove because he's afraid of the possible like Tyrion and things later that he needs to
possible
silence.
Everything. Blessing of Kings, Belcher, Tyrion,
silence,
Savannah.
Yeah.
I don't think you're thinking 4 turns down the line. I think you might even put the Keeper at the base here.
Yeah, that's true. He is at 19. I like the way you're thinking.
Yeah. It's just nice to swipe next turn, which is the most realistic play anyways, besides Savage or Phase.
Do we actually keep her face here?
I would keep her the 1-1 though, because we're kind of afraid of Kings, aren't we? Kings and possibly Quarter.
Well, we saw Zombies, but I guess you can't really make the read that it's mid-range.
Yeah, well, you don't know if it's mid-range or 4 Secrets Paladin.
Yeah.
There's the 2 different versions.
I like what Surrender's doing here. The full Smork strategy. I think that's the heads-up play.
Yeah. He's so definitely finding a way to work with the cards in his hand.
The Trucer is doing some work here, cleaning out the board nice and efficiently. So just drop the Shredder.
Does he even swing at Darnassus here, or does he swing at the other one?
Oh, you swing at Darnassus. I mean, the Shredder trades into the Keeper anyway.
I mean, denying a possible 6-drop like Savannah's might be really important.
Yeah, you saw your opponent didn't have any 5s.
Yeah.
So, like...
I guess it blocks Force of Nature base. Because that's probably what you're expecting at this point when you just Keepers your base instead of your dude.
I don't think the Shade is a bad draw. It kind of synergizes with the 7-draw pretty well and a swipe to the face.
Yeah. And a swipe to the face.
It is a lot of potential damage.
We could just commit here and just like hear about face too.
Yeah.
He's thinking about it.
Is it worth it though?
He's definitely counting it out here to try and plan.
Yeah.
Four from the Shade, and then he's going to have 4 from the Savage Roar. That's going to be 8. And then 4 from the Swipe is going to be 12. And then he can squeeze in 2 hero powers during that. So that's like 14, assuming he draws no more damage.
And assuming Orange has nothing is the...
Nothing as far as like taunts or heals. You know?
Yeah, the bigger Crusader.
Wow.
He is one aggressive
That is
person.
One pride player right there.
Yeah, I mean, but it's still like one off even if he spaces it all out.
Yeah, Druid has damage.
Yeah, that's true. That is true. Druid has a lot of damage.
So, this Paladin, man. Do you just drop the Belshren from a Paladin's perspective next turn?
Yeah, at this point, things have been going at your face a lot. You play the guy with taunt.
Yeah.
Oh!
It is Secrets Paladin, huh? Yeah, it's the 4 Secrets.
Yeah, yeah. Being this low on health though is like really scary for your Paladin because you don't have like the heal button,
yeah,
you don't
have
the lay on hands. It's like being this low is very scary, and he makes the aggressive low foot play.
Well, I mean, he doesn't have heals, so he's got to kill his opponent before his opponent kills him.
Ooh, and dead draw, completely dead.
Wow, Lothep again doing work.
Yeah, it's 2 games in a row.
I mean, do you?
No, you still Lothep?
I mean, aren't we already committed to the plan?
All face, all the time.
But I mean, it doesn't set up lethal, right? Because that only goes up to four, and then we have four, and then four, so we're one off.
It kind of doesn't make sense to let a Shredder alive there.
All right. We see the trades coming out.
Nah, I don't like this change of game plan.
Well, I mean, he's one off. So he's I mean, he could top deck Innervate, but he's only got one left in the deck.
This is how you win championships.
Yeah, but I mean, he's also got Ancient Allure you could fall back on. I think it's better to play to your Ancient Allure.
That Ancient Allure is going to be a rough drop next turn. Like,
he's so far behind.
He's losing so much tempo.
I mean, not drawing a creature rare like Hero Power Turn 6, that throws him so far behind. And the board is quite powerful from the Paladin side.
All right. It looks like he's committing to the... No?
Oh.
He's very hesitant.
That's a tough decision. He really does want to hit him in the face.
He wants a Doomsayer here is what he wants.
Oh.
That is not good for him
either. That's one Pendla Lord.
Giving Paladins Savage right here is pretty bad.
Yeah, they tend to have a lot of things on the board.
Yeah.
I don't know, man. Lawwalker Cho, he likes to sneak into tournaments. He just likes that.
Definitely.
Now, Pagel, Lawwalker Cho. They all make appearances. Hey, Firebat, draw four?
Yeah. Oh, the combo comes into the hand. So if he finds a way to get through this Belcher and stay alive till turn nine.
Dude. Does that mean you just heal this lore? Because if you just heal the lore next turn, you can swipe something and clear the slime, and then you're free to explode into the Paladin's face with the combo.
Yeah, it seems reasonable line of play.
This Lawwalker is making things a little bit awkward, though.
Yeah, definitely for sure.
Yeah, and it's not going to work out because Tyrion's in the hand. Still, I think this is the best play. Just healing up.
I mean, you're not winning on board. You got to figure out an alternate way to win the game.
You got to cheese him out.
Yeah, you got to cheese him by going face, so... Figuring out the best way to do that with this Lorewalker Cho is, it looks like it's got to be Ancient Allure, because you don't want to just give your Paladin opponent more spells to kill you with.
Yeah, that seems bad.
Yeah, counterproductive.
That's a heads up play. I like it.
Surrender figures out, gets the heal in. Surrender is playing real. Oh boy.
Dude,
two sludges in Secret Paladin?
Yeah, that is.
Orange is reinventing the meta.
Yeah, that is. It's going deep.
And hair fashion. Mainly hair fashion, though.
Yeah, so I guess he's probably only running like one Quartermaster because the
old
like the Four Secret Paladin, the original one by like Cross like months ago.
That has a Quartermaster now?
Yeah, one Belcher, one Quarter.
Oh, yeah. I was just raging about nothing because I didn't think this was a real deck, and I was like, oh, you luck dog.
This is the old number one Legend deck from a while ago. It's kind of been like out of fashion.
Yeah,
Tice is kind of revamped with the 6 Secret version, and then there's the 8 Secret version, and then there's just.
There's a whole bunch of secret versions.
Yeah, there's just all the Paladins.
Eye for an Eye is a good card.
Turns out you can put a bunch of cards in Paladin, and it's pretty good.
It tends to be like really good against Druid, especially like this version of the Aldor and the Belchers. Like, Thorn of Fury can't go face.
Oh, man.
He's trying.
This version looks good against Druid.
It's like, it's like the Belchers on their own are like 14 health more.
Well, Force Nature Savage will be 7, Swipe will be 10, so if you Emperor, you can't do everything.
Okay. But if you top deck Innervate, you can do everything.
And
but
win.
Can you get through two Belchers?
No. 4, 8. No. It'd be like 4 off lethal.
All right.
It's almost there.
It doesn't quite work. Like, oh man, like double Belcher. And where's Tyrion coming up, right? We forgot about this one.
Well, there's already two Sludge Belchers on board. Let's not worry about Tyrion yet. Like, that's a problem for another day.
You gotta assume he doesn't have Tyrion and try and construct a game plan to win.
What I like about Paladins, they have beautiful curves. Man, look at this.
Yeah.
Like, but no Dr. 6 or Dr. 7, but Dr. 8 is gonna be enough. And the Druid is also getting kind of low on health, right?
Oh, yeah. Druid's running out of time real quick here. And this Tyrion's gonna clock him.
Oh, yeah. Tyrion is a big threat. It's 5-3 weapon.
Should Orange just go all phase here?
Ignore the Emperor?
Yeah.
I think that's one of the ways he could possibly lose the game. Oh, he's trading off the taunt, though.
I mean, this is a huge taunt. Well, yeah, you might as well just go for the value game. Sure. What are you afraid of?
Yeah, exactly.
You could have traded off, like, the Juggler and the Chao.
Yeah. And you have, anyways, a Chao on the board, so...
Like, he kept the Juggler alive instead of a Sludge Belcher.
Yeah.
Kind of questionable, I guess. Juggler's really good, though.
Yeah, it's a good 2-drop.
Sets up to kill the Shade of Conscript.
Yeah, it's a good 2-drop, but Belcher is a good
off the top.
5-drop.
That good enough?
So if we silence this huge Paladin Lord and kill the Belcher, Can we actually go for a lethal? I don't think so, right?
Well, yeah, you can silence and swipe.
Yeah, silence, swipe hero power this turn, and then how much damage?
Oh, are you just dead on board because you give your opponent swipe because of the Laura Walker show?
Oh, shit, yeah.
Okay, I got it.
That Laura Walker show.
That Laura Walker show.
So you,
well, if you think about it, though, like if Laura Walker show was any other 2-drop, it would have done so much more damage than swipe would have done.
Guys, I have the idea. You swing it to the Belcher with the Shade, and then hero power the slime, and next turn you can combo and swipe the other slime. Have a clear board and win the game, right?
A combo and...
Silence the Tyrion.
Kill one Belcher.
Yeah, you can swipe. You can do everything next turn, right?
Yeah, you can do everything.
Big mistakes.
Silencing the Belcher is actually better.
Is it?
Yeah, because Tyrion's going to be...
Oh, you gave him swipe, though.
Because the Shade goes just into the Tyrion, as long as you're not dead.
Okay, super smart.
Wow, Surrender is next level.
He is on fire.
There's 6, 11, 15 with the swipe, 17 with the consecrate.
Oh, feels bad.
That was so next level, though. That was insane. I did not see that.
Wait, was that better than the one saving swipe for next turn? Because you could still set up a lethal with saving swipe for next turn, yeah?
Yeah, that was actually better, yeah.
Yeah.
Then you're not dead this turn.
Then you're not dead.
But there's a chance of working.
It was, like, really complicated to see, right?
Yeah. It was hard to see, but I don't know.
Surrender's really good. Yeah, I'm surprised you didn't see it, actually.
He made the second best play here.
Feels bad, man.
Yeah. JJ, the Paladin Master, saw the play, though.
Oh, come on. It was a fucking Druid play.
He's so good at Paladin, he sees Druid plays.
Loa Cocholo.
Oh, man. All right. Now we just got to think about Surrender's counter-queuing into mid...
Secret Paladin? We only got to see one secret out of that deck.
Yeah, the deck's still kind of a secret.
I see what you did there. I see what you did there.
Oh, man.
So we got a 1-1. So we have Orange with the Paladin next. What does Surrender have left?
He has...
A Warrior?
Warrior and Hunter?
Yeah, Warrior and Hunter, right?
Yeah.
He chooses...
It has to be Patron.
It has to be Patron. Yeah, I mean, he's on Na'vi, kind of. He's got the jacket. Yeah, they all play the Patron.
They're all representing the meme.
When you see Na'vi step to the table, you know Patron.
Patron, that deck, illegal.
Yeah.
Is True Silver not a keep?
It is, definitely, right?
Maybe not.
Maybe he doesn't know if it's Patron or not, I guess.
I mean...
He's wearing a Na'vi jacket.
We didn't know it was Patron.
We also just saw the Na'vi jacket.
Yeah, he's like sneaking in Na'vi. He's like under the radar still.
Okay.
Yeah. The jacket wasn't enough of a tell. It was too soon.
Also, we're very sorry we spoiled things, Na'vi. Please don't be mad at us.
All right.
So...
I don't think this matchup is as bad as people think for the Paladin.
I mean, never played this...
This matchup goes like this, right? Turn 4, Death Spite. Turn 5, Patron, Inner Rage.
No, they have to get lucky to get that to happen.
Oh, okay, I know. I
the Juggler Prey turn.
Yeah, if this juggler sticks, this Coghammer is going to be insane.
Oh, baby.
Oh, my. Yeah.
I mean, Orange is probably going to play around Coin Death Spite and actually put the damage on the Juggler before he Coghammers it. So then the Execute is actually going to be an option for...
Execute.
The meme.
That's a bit, that's pretty good.
Yeah, I would play that card.
Yeah.
That is Doctor 3, right?
And there's no Whirlwind effect for a Patron yet, and no Patron as well, so is it even a Patron Warrior?
Who knows, man?
Maybe it's just Pirate Warrior. We do see a Pirate.
Oh, he's looking to trade into the Armorsmith first, maybe?
Yeah, you trade into the Armorsmith first, then you muster, right?
Yeah.
I mean, if you're afraid of Whirlwind, you maybe Coghammer.
I don't think he knows it's Patron, so I don't think he's fearing the Whirlwinds.
Oh.
Maybe he is. He's picking up the Coghammer a little bit.
I mean, Coghammer is a really good card against the weapons.
Ooh. This Execute, though.
Yeah, that Execute.
Picking up some value here. It's on a 2-drop, but killing Knife Juggler is really good.
Especially when with Divine Shield.
Yeah, even better.
Oh, he would have top decked the Whirlwind, so it's good he went with this play.
Orange is a genius.
Yeah, he sees the future.
Does he know it's Patron? That play suggests he knows it's Patron.
Yeah. He's got a hunch.
Smart guy, Orange.
He's figured out. He saw the jacket.
So do you execute the Juggler, though? Is it, like, necessary? I think you want to put off the pressure off the board.
Oh, yeah. Juggler's hurt. I would kill it.
Yeah, I guess so.
Do you coin the Acolyte to go with that, or? You're saving that coin for Dr. B.
I think you just, like, execute it and then, like, try and coin Lothab, yeah?
What secret is that?
What if
there?
You just play Acolyte and pass? The Juggler's going to trade in and you can roll an XG next turn?
I don't know. And then they play a Shredder.
I mean, don't you want to save the coin for the bombastic turn?
You're really...
Yeah.
Coin boom I can see it out here.
Like, if you get this Acolyte out here, you're, like, guaranteeing you get two draws off of it, so that's fine.
Surrender doesn't even know it's Secret Paladin.
Oh, that's true.
There is a secret,
well, there's a
on
secret
the Paladin set, so it might
oh,
be...
Oh, no, he doesn't, yeah, okay. Yeah. Oh, he played that on turn one. What is that, actually?
I think it's Sacrifice, right?
We'll see if the Noble Sacrifice lights up yellow or not.
Yeah. Oh, that's a good card.
Ooh, that's the best card.
That is the one you want to draw. That enables him to play Dread Corsair as
oh,
well.
Oh, so we're just missing the Patron, right?
Yeah, just the Patron in the Inner Age, and then you're good to go.
Oh, you get two draws off the Sacrifice anyways.
Yeah, because the Noble Sacrifice.
He can't even play the Pirate, like, on the turn of Death Spells, like, really strong.
Yeah.
So we get a second Whirlwind. That's a lot of...
That is a lot of dream.
That's a lot of wind.
Yeah. Feels good, man?
Yeah, feels bad, man, for Paladin.
Yeah.
Oh, that's good. Doomsayer making another appearance.
How weird is it, though? Like,
good ordering, holding back the Dread Corsair, I guess.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, kind of. Because like, then there's like the guy that makes things cost one more mana that comes into play. Like, it just depends what card you off Shredder you want to lose to, really.
Sure.
How good is that Lothab? It just dies to Deathbite, but you kind of have to bait out the Deathbite hit, so it's kind of hard here.
Yeah.
But you might just hold on to it and play the Noble Sacrifice to get like double value.
Given the hand, though, you gotta bait out the.
You could have went
Death Spite because you have a Mustard Battle. That's so weak.
Yeah,
I guess
this Death Spite is just eating the board.
Yeah, and
you might just go Pirate into Lothab.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. Well, the Pirate just actually dies to the Coghammer.
That's true, actually.
Oh, that's sad.
Might as well just actually just hold the Pirate. You'll get value with the Fire War Axe. You'll be able to play at a discount anyways turn after.
I like that line a lot.
And what you can do is we drop the Pirate. Next turn we can swing with Despot and Whirlwind, remove the board.
Yeah, Surrender sees it and he's like, I need this Pirate to carry me later.
Yeah.
Keeping the Pirate in full health.
Not giving your opponent's weapons value.
Oh, Blessing of Kings is a good pickup.
Lothab has been so good every time it's been played. Yeah. Series. It's insane.
It's almost like it's a good card.
It's pretty good. Yeah. Especially
I'm
going to
start putting that in all my decks.
Yeah, we
I'm
should
learning
do
something.
Yeah.
Oh, baby. Ooh. Well, is that the play this turn? Because next turn you want to play Boom, right?
You might equip the War Axe, just clear the board, and next turn you can just go really ham.
You can make a lot of patrons, but is that better than playing Boom? Because Boom's really good, too. You can make, like, what, one, two, three patrons next
so
turn?
So you're saying me there's a better play on seven than
actually,
playing Boom?
I think that's what I'm saying. There isn't.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, you got to play Boom on turn seven. So I think you just patron Whirlwind, trade down the board. It's like he can't clear all the patrons anyway.
Surrender disagrees.
Yeah, Surrender disagrees.
It was bad, man. Too.
I mean, he's in a very dominant position.
He definitely is. Do you kill the 1-1 to protect the Pirate?
I personally would.
I like my Pirate. Like, he's a bro.
But 5 damage to the face?
But then the Pirate dies to
five
the
5 damage to the face is not worth a bro.
The weapon plus the 1-1 kills the Pirate. He's thinking about it a lot, moving his mouse around like crazy.
And his opponent is at 29. Like, Orange is at 29, so.
No, he's at 24, man.
Taking the damage.
That's a good card.
There you go.
Well, let's find out how many secrets Orange runs.
Yeah, this will answer a lot of questions about his deck, and we'll be able to determine things like, does he run Aldor or not?
The big thing, though, is if he actually runs Repentance, which is one of the most common ones to cut, and it is insane right now.
Oh, yeah. It's usually in the Four Secret Paladin. So if he is running the Four Secret Paladin, it should be in there.
It can't be with 2 Noble Sacks, 1 Repentance, 1 Avenge?
Wait, he had... He's already had 2 Noble Sacks, so it's got to be a 6 Secret version. So he probably doesn't have Aldors. Sure.
Can the Dwarves take the challenge, though, Kappa?
I was really thinking of not playing Challenger, and I feel like that's a mistake.
Yeah, I would strongly suggest that the Challenger comes down.
That card's good. You think on turns, is it better than Dr. Boom this turn?
But I mean, maybe it's off curve. Yeah. It's off curve by a turn. Doesn't that just feel bad?
It does.
It's still decent.
It's still decent.
And it's not going to be a full Christmas tree.
We get
three
including the Noble Sack.
So there's Noble Sacrifice, probably Avenge.
Oh, no, there's a fourth.
Oh.
The animation is a bit slow.
So that might actually be Repentance?
It might be.
It's either Repentance or Competitive, right?
Yeah. That's usually the ones that people switch in and out with each other. So we'll see his tech choice and see how it pays out for him here.
So Patron's a complete disaster. Boom, getting Repentance is not that bad, given there's like not a Consecrate or anything like that.
Yeah, I mean, like, you still get the Boom Bots, so that's always good.
So it's between Boom and Belcher here?
Yeah. There's no way you YOLO the Patron out.
Yeah, it's just too risky.
It's like the best card in this matchup. You might as well keep it.
Yeah. And you got two Whirlwinds to go with it, you know.
I think you gotta go Boom.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's the strongest play on the board.
No Repentance.
No Repentance.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, that is scary.
Yeah.
So,
does he actually...
I don't think attacking is right here.
It gives him a... It gives him, like, the redemption will go off, so then he ends up with 3-2, the Avenge goes off, and a 10-9, right?
Yeah, and he ends up actually...
And you're dead to Blessed Champion.
Yeah.
I mean,
you actually improved the board strength by attacking there.
All right, looks like he plays Competitive Spirits instead of Repentance.
Surrender has been so solid this set. Like, he's playing so good.
And there's a Tyrion.
That was like, Orange is playing really good, too.
Yeah. Orange is playing very well as well.
Been impressed.
Is it even worth like making the value trade into low FF here, given that there's Boombots on the board?
We just make an 11-11 Challenger and go face, right? I
mean. Oh!
Executes a card, man.
You already saw one on your 3-1 Knife Juggler.
Yeah.
Why are we not playing Tyrion? Like, what is the downside?
He's gonna play Tyrion.
Yeah.
He's gonna play Tyrion.
Isn't there also a Redemption on the board? So that's kind of sketchy for the Boria.
Oh, wow, yeah. The Redemption's insane. Then you go face with the 7-7, so your 7-7 doesn't die to Boombots and Tyrion comes back?
The Redemption's gonna work on the Noble Sacrifice.
That's a problem.
Yeah. Noble Sacrifice is working against you here. But Tyrion's still big with the Divine Shield and Taunt.
I mean, without an Execute, that's a hell of a board to deal with.
Yeah, that is tough.
Where is this
challenger
going?
And then you get the
weapon,
and you can keep applying pressure.
It's not going into a Boomba.
It's
got to
be face. Ooh.
I like face.
I like face a lot. Like, it's a damage race, man. You got to get that weapon out there and start swinging.
That's true.
So Noble Sack triggers, Avenge is going to go off, and Redemption's going to go off.
Right, so this Boombot on the Challenger seems juicy. Well,
it looked like it was going there.
Yeah, kind of the direction, but failed at a whole half trip.
That is a big Tyrion.
That is a big Tyrion. So let's see if the 7-2 can weather the storm here. Even if it does, though, it dies to the double Whirlwind.
Yeah.
Which, oh boy, that's coming out this turn, isn't it?
Yeah. It's got to be Patron double Whirlwind.
Oh boy.
That's a huge deal.
Yeah, that's a lot of patrons.
I did not realize this turn was that good for... and phase is actually the best result, I guess.
Yeah.
Yeah, so...
Yeah, you don't kill Brother Minion.
And
damage.
The meme lives. The meme freaking lives.
Everybody's getting in here.
Four patrons.
I mean, it's still a good card.
It really is.
Yeah, Patron definitely can hold its weight against aggressive decks.
Especially played piloted by Na'vi members. They seem to be... really good at the deck.
So interesting, like, if this Patron version is already so strong, how strong was the old Patron?
It was busted, and that's really why I got nerfed. Oh, boy. Oh. Orange realizes he can't win by going face.
I mean, look at this turn 9 from the Warrior. It's so good.
Yeah, and the big problem with, like, the Patrons being there is Paladin can no longer utilize the hero power.
That
has to be the nail in the coffin.
Ow. Feels bad.
That hurt.
Oh, and the Armorsmith behind the Belcher. It's like really good.
Oh, yeah. Now you just can't even die. Like, he was already winning, and now it's just done.
Wow.
Yeah.
Orange might as well surrender.
that's actually not going to get old. Oh. He might actually just be setting up Lethal here. I didn't do the math, but I'm assuming that's what he's doing.
It seems like a smart thing in this situation.
That's going to be a lot of damage, so.
Yeah.
4, 6, and then, that sets up Lethal. His 12 on board, 13 on board.
Yeah, that is a big Frothing Berserker. Doesn't have charge, though, so it's much weaker than its previous version.
Yeah. And don't even get to see the card from Orange.
But, I mean, Orange had a really good curve, but...
Patron's good.
Yeah.
I have to say, like, Surrender played this so well.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah, I liked it a lot.
I like the part, like the best play of the game, I think, is when he top deck Deathblade on turn 4.
Oh, yeah, that card makes a huge difference.
Yeah, that was a really good play.
Yeah, and Orange had a few plays like that, too, where he was able to get Mysterious Challenger and Tyrion, but yeah, the matchup, I guess, is pretty heavily patron-based.
I think this is also good for patron.
I would assume so, yeah. It's been
Unstable goes really good.
Yeah.
Is it like pure face hunter or hybrid?
Hybrid, I believe.
Yeah. I think that matchup is not too bad for hybrid hunter because patron seems to struggle sometimes with really super aggressive decks, and hybrid hunter is that.
Oh, that is.
Yeah, but hybrid hunter is going to need a really sick curve, especially to deal with Unstable Ghoul.
Unstable Ghoul is so good, but he has a bow in the hand, so that works.
All right.
I kind of like just giving seeing the mulligan. I'd like to kind of see Orange hold off on the one drop here.
Is this...
You want him to go coin two?
Coin... Well, no, just hold off, do nothing here.
And then go coin companion.
Yeah.
I do...
Because the creeper doesn't actually do anything.
That's true.
Abuse Surgeon's probably better than creeper here.
I mean, if you can get that animal companion down before Deathbite, sometimes it can just carry the whole match.
Coin Huffer hit, like, for 12, 16.
Yeah.
Maybe 20 even. That's definitely the dream.
We have to say it's like a super heads-up play here, holding onto the coin, because the bow is really important.
Yeah.
Do you even want to drop the ghoul now, because the value is kind of meh?
It's not about value in this matchup. It's about jamming things out there.
Yeah, it's about just not dying until you find your patron combo. Yeah. That's all you gotta do is just stay alive, and then eventually everyone gets in here in your home. Wow.
But this bow is going to change a lot of things. You just bow into companion. Seems solid.
Yeah, it seems insane.
Coin holding huffer off is not the play here.
Yeah, holding off on that coin was really good.
Now there are two huffers in Orange's hand.
Feels bad, man. Bow not going to the face.
Feels good, dude. Taking care of Unstable Ghoul, that's such a huge...
Yeah, one for one with... Or less, better than one for one with Unstable Ghoul is insane. Yeah.
It's so weird in Hearthstone how, like, these little plays here that everyone thinks are pretty insignificant and, like, how you use the coin in the first three turns usually decide how the game snowballs.
That's true, yeah. But since Surrender is going to top deck a Death Spite, this game is over, right?
Yep, that's my elf. Oh, that's not Huffer. Oh.
Well, he's got the Execute to still deal
with.
Yeah, and the Deathbite.
Deathbite's just...
And the Deathbite,
Deathbite's really good here.
Oh! Oh my god.
Surrender is just really good at the game.
Oh, he's thinking about emoting, but then decides against it.
Orange is salty.
I kind of saw that coming.
Oh my god. That is so disgusting.
That was the best play by far.
He has Patron Innerage Swing now. The game is over.
Yeah.
This is the old broken stuff that everybody wanted to nerf.
Yep.
He hit it.
Oh boy.
You don't come back from this. He's got Battle Rage to follow it up. This is the end.
What if he survives to like Acid Maw? Is that the one that deals with patrons good?
Yeah, if he web spinners off Acid Maw and then magically gets 10 mana, then he can unleash the Hound's Acid Maw.
That seems like a good out to me.
I don't think that even works because I think it still replicates a patron when you hit it with the Hound.
Does it?
Yeah.
Oh, jeez. This is rough. I mean, I don't think there's any outs for...
I mean, are you missing anything? I mean, you have Battle Rage, Armorsmith, Execute. I think you're... Oh.
He's got the whole toolkit.
He can kill all of them using the Arcane Golem. Ooh, Leok could be huge.
He's got the...
Oh, yeah, if you get Leok, he's huge.
Yeah, Leok.
Yeah, he can actually clear here.
Oh, my God. Impressive. I think it's a more of a winning play to go for Companion Leok. Does Huffer work?
Huffer would work, yeah.
Yeah, Huffer
works. Arcane Golem would work.
Yeah. So Companion is pretty good here.
Yeah, go for Companion.
You have to clear the dwarfs.
Oh boy.
Isn't it funny if you clear the dwarfs, like how good of a spot it is?
He's starting with the abusive, so I think he's leaning towards maybe the Arcane Golem.
Yeah, I mean, it's like a 100% clear. I can understand him there.
Yeah?
Who can blame it?
Sure.
And actually, Surrender doesn't have a Whirlwind here, so...
Yeah.
Wow.
Looking good.
The blue guy is getting in there.
If Surrender gets the Dr. Boom here, holy...
Oh my god! Holy crap!
JJ, when I play
I don't want to play against you. This isn't fair.
Oh my
god. Orange is just in pain. Look at him. This is your fault. You're doing this to him.
You just have a voodoo over him. This is horrible, JJ.
Keeps happening, man.
Wow. Well, I mean, he could roll Leok and maybe make some things happen.
Yeah, Leok's pretty cool here. Yeah. Plus 5 damage.
Yeah. Easy Leok.
No, that's awkward.
All right, what animal companion is it going to be?
Yeah, Huffer. No.
Oh, whoa.
Second Misha.
Yeah, but I'm like more of the curve doctor. I'm not that good of a hunter player.
Sure. Because you're the paladin guy.
Yeah.
Oh, he's probably also the best patron in the world. Like, do you see how he's calling guards?
Yeah.
He's probably the best patron in the world.
I mean...
Oh, he's going to give it the skill
if
here.
You give your opponent an arcane gold mana crystal into mana into 7.
I don't think that's actually a big deal against patron.
Yeah, they only have one.
I mean,
yeah. Oh, it was a big deal. Leaving the boom bots up. That's. Oh no! Ooh,
wow. Double armor smith is
that good?
Yeah. It's decent.
Oh boy. And I think we're gonna see Orange roll his eyes one more time this match.
It's gonna be a bombastic turn.
Kappa. Did the boom bots also clear the board?
Oh yeah.
Every time. The Misha dies. Is it kind of weird, but they always go for like the 4 health minion, never for the hounds or something.
Oh, no. It kills Azurdrake 100%.
Or when you're at like 6 health, they always just kill you and ignore the 10 minions on board.
Yeah. Or they put you in fireball range.
Yeah, that happened to me earlier.
Yeah.
That was ridiculous.
Oh, that was a top deck fireball, by the way.
Yeah, I know. I was watching the game. I was playing.
Were you?
For that. Talking trash. Let's just wait for top 8, little buddy.
Let's just get in your head before we play again, okay?
Okay. You're gonna get smashed.
Okay. I mean, this Misha, she's dying.
Yeah.
Hey, you just attack.
Yeah, I definitely.
He could use the execute, I guess.
Poor bear. Feels bad, man.
Prioritizing face damage.
Face!
I love how much this guy goes face.
Yeah,
this guy's awesome.
Very aggressive.
This guy knows where the place is.
I mean, double armor smith, that's like too much.
Oh. Unleash does not do anything against two armor smiths.
Yeah, well, I mean, there's 5 minions, so you get 5 hounds. That's insane value for a card.
With the bow, you can actually kill both armorsmiths here.
Yeah, it's
true. Yeah, 1 trillion armor.
Well, Surrender's Hand is really dead. If he doesn't top deck something...
If he kills all the things that are more than 1 health, he's actually in a good spot. I think Patron might be better at top decking, though.
I mean, the Hunter's going to top deck high main, so it doesn't seem like a problem.
And he's not killing armor.
Not killing second armor.
So there's going to be, like, 3 new cards here.
Yeah. Ooh.
I mean, Orange obliges and... Oh, boy. Actually, this is really good if it kills the last hound. It blocks Battle Rage.
I guess. Ooh, Lothab's a bad one.
That's a 5-5.
And you can play it with the Battle Rage, which is important.
Yeah. Oh. And that's... Oh, that's...
Surrender.
Very handsome.
Oh, there we go again.
Okay, there we go.
And Choppy with the Fiery.
Oh, yeah. You start just...
I mean, what
pressure.
Does the Hunter need? And also, like, he's getting low on life.
Oh, yeah. I mean... Okay. I mean, the clock's, I guess, the same, right? You still need
3, 12. Yeah, you still need 2 turns anyway.
So might as well squeeze in the armor while you have the mana.
Doesn't really help. Like, a quick shot would be a decent pickup.
JJ, be optimistic. How does Orange win this game?
A quick shot into... I guess he's like a quick shot into second shredder, something that helps. But I don't think Orange runs Belchers.
Well... He could get a Doomsayer off the Shredder to slow down his opponent.
There's been a lot of Doomsayers going on.
And then he can top deck, like, Malagos or a 9-drop.
Out of all the 9-drops, the first thing that comes to my mind is Malagos and Hunter.
I mean, maybe he's running, like, some Lock and Load.
King Crush?
Oh, King Crush.
Like, is that not more likely?
That's probably more likely, yeah. Sorry. Yeah, Orange just needs to crush him.
King Crush would actually probably catch him up here. For you kids at home, trying to make good 100 decks right there.
There was no Doomsayer. So we still got to deal with this massive board.
No, I just go face here, have a good life.
I mean, no, it's
yeah, you're sitting at 33 health on turn 10 against the Hunter. Feels good.
Yeah, he doesn't have to deal with the board, but Orange definitely.
Oh boy, Orange is sad.
Yeah.
Oh man, that Dr. Womb dropped.
Yeah. JJ actually probably won the game for Surrender on his own calling cards.
No, I'm not as good.
Oh, that's call it. That's pretty good, though.
It's not bad.
And, you can't play that, at least for Orange. Deathwing? Oh, boy.
If Orange and gets a Deathwing, he could be in it. Nope, there's an execute. He's got all the answers, man.
Oh, and that should be... man.
There's no card that really helps him here. It feels a bit weird.
Yeah.
He didn't even get one.
He can stay alive. Orange is a fighter.
Yeah. I tend to concede before I trade with Arcane Golem, though. That guy is supposed to go face.
Man, he played it out to the end. Never surrendered.
Surrender played insane. He is good.
Yeah, he played out.
He's really good.
I mean, he made one in this huge series. He made one really small misplay.
Yeah, with the druid lethal setup.
I can't name too many people who would actually would have seen that play. That was a really
was
tough turn. There was two Belchers and a Tyrion on board, and there was like
a Lorewalker Cho. Yeah.
And like, there was a Lorewalker Cho. There was definitely a puzzle going on there.
It was a nice puzzle. I liked it.
Yeah, I mean, it's probably one you see on Reddit or something sometime.
Yeah, it's cool.
Hearthstone.
And I look at them and I'm like, no, I can't do this.
Gosh. Winner's interview.
Surrender, buddy. How are you doing?
What's up?
What's up?
He's overjoyed.
Surrender, you're very good at drawing Deathbite on turn 4. Can you teach me?
Skill.
So how does it feel?
Good.
Yeah, I mean you're wearing a nice jacket there. Like,
tell us about Navi. What's going on?
I don't know what's going on, but Sito gave me a shot.
Okay.
Wait, Navi's giving free stuff away and I didn't get one? This is ridiculous.
All right. What do you think about Patron in the current metagame?
I think Patron is really good now.
Better than before?
No. Still good.
All right, but why do you think it's good?
There are so many paladins and hunters and druids.
Okay.
Yeah, it's quite good. Yeah,
there you go. There you go.
We saw it this series. You farmed them.
Yeah.
So how much did you prepare for this tournament?
Honestly, I didn't prepare a lot because Sixo played Overwatch all the time.
Seems good. It's a good game, I heard.
So you were living with Zigzo for like the last couple weeks?
Yeah.
And just only Overwatch?
Okay.
All right.
Nice. You played really well. Heads up. So, nice performance, huh?
Yeah, congrats.
One more series and we advance. Well played.
Thank you.
Hey, good luck, dude.
Good job, Surrender.
All right, so we're going to go to a quick break, and then we'll be right back with the next series.